Hello everyone, that's Vincenzo Piccolo from Dermatology Unit of University of Campania Luigi Vanvitelli. And in this first video of 2023, I'm going to talk about common viral infection of the skin. As I mostly deal with children, you will see patients of young age with infection of the skin in the next slides on my presentation. We can't talk about viral infections without referring to viral warts. They are definitely one of the most common infections of the skin, mostly in children, secondary to the infection by HPV, the human papilloma virus infection. In this case, the patient presents with the so-called flat warts, so verruca plana of the face, characterized by this very slightly elevated flat lesion, usually affecting the face, like in this patient. In flat warts, we can see also the so-called Kebner phenomenon, the presence of warts in cutaneous sites affected by previous trauma, like scratching in this patient. Another kind of warts usually affecting children is the filiform warts, usually occurring in the periorificial areas, like in this patient. I'm also showing you the dermatoscopy of this kind of infection, characterized by this filiform projection, sometimes associated with vessels that are most commonly seen in verruca vulgaris, more than filiform warts. This is another patient with warts affecting the periungual area, another common location for, in this case, verruca vulgaris, or common wart characterized at dermatoscopy by the presence of all these thrombosed vessels, well seen at also at lower magnification. In this tennis player, once again, the Kebner phenomenon characterized by the post-traumatic occurrence of warts, we can see one wart for each finger, characterized by the same dermatoscopic appearance that we saw before, namely the presence of these thrombosed vessels that are at the center of each white papilla seen in the warts. In this patient, it's very nice to see how the hyperhidrotic foot is affected by different common infection. We see a plantar warts, a keratolysis, a pitted keratolysis, and also the tinea pedis in this area. But we will discuss in the next videos about this non-viral infection. Warts in the plantar area can sometimes appear in this way when we have a confluence of different warts together, and this is the so-called mosaic wart. It's very difficult to treat in this case because we should associate different treatment and exclude a condition of immune suppression in our patient. This is another patient who developed this annular wart because of a previous strong treatment with cryotherapy that provoked a peripheral spread of the viral infection with a central scar in this area. Also, this patient may be very challenging to treat. Another very challenging condition in which sometimes we should also exclude child abuse is the presence of warts in perianal region, in this case in children, but we know that it's a very common sexual transmitted infection in adult patients. And just to switch to another topic, I'm going to start with this new kind of infection, Molluscum contagiosum, that sometimes can appear in genital and perianal area. In this case, the dermatoscopic appearance is different and is characterized by this whitish area at the center of lesion surrounded by crown vessels. This is another case of isolated molluscum in which the presence of typical dermatoscopic features makes the diagnosis easier. Molluscum is provoked by pox virus, so a virus that is different from viral warts. And in this case, we see a diffuse infection of the gluteal fold characterized by this multiple lesion, small one, where we see this rosette-like appearance at the center of the molluscum and confluence of multiple lesion in this other area. Sometimes molluscum deserves one presentation apart because it's a very large topic, can be associated to an eczema that can be an attempt of immune system to resolve the spontaneously the infection. But we see here at dermatoscopy that molluscum is still present in this patient. It's rare to see, but we can find molluscum also at plantar area. This is the central orifice, and this is the peripheral area of the molluscum itself. Another infection that is commonly seen in patients, both children and adults, is the herpes virus infection, the herpes simplex, that is characterized by clusters of vesicles, usually affecting the perioral region. Like in this case, it's rare to see in very young children, like in this patient, but we can see it everywhere, like on the shoulder in this patient, on the face, zygomatic area with recurrent infection affecting this patient. The first infection is usually the most severe one, by then followed by milder episodes of the same infection. Another infection provoked by an herpes virus is the varicella. In Italy, we see a lot of cases of that infection characterized by a polymorphism in the eruption of the infection itself. And the same virus, varicella zoster virus, can provoke also this kind of infection, that is the herpes zoster, often metameric, so following the course of a peripheral nerve and characterized by these clusters of small vesicles, often associated with pain and burning sensation. This is the same patient seen at the back. This is another case in a child characterized by this, you see, linear metameric localization of herpes zoster, but usually in children, it's not associated with the same pain as we see in adult too. Viral herpes viral infection can also be a complication, a severe complication of atopic dermatitis, like in this child, which developed so-called kaposi variceliform eruption or eczema herpeticum. That is a complication with herpes virus infection over previously existing atopic dermatitis. This is another very common infection, usually affecting children, but also in adults, that we must recognize because it is going to change over the years, the so-called hand, foot, and mouth disease. It is associated with the echovirus or Coxsackie virus. This is the typical eruption with perioral vesicles, plantar lesion, and palmar lesion as well. We have also other kind of infections secondary to viruses, so not directly associated with the virus, but you see as the consequence of immune activation induced by the virus, like the so-called Giannotti-Crossi disease, this papular eruption usually affecting young children characterized by these papules on arms and thigh that are secondary to the immune activation in usually affecting atopic patients and lasting more than 4-6 weeks, sometimes also 12 weeks in this patient, but they are benign condition. We should recognize them just to reassure their parents, and after that follow the spontaneous resolution of the condition itself. Another condition that probably belongs to the same group of pyroviral infection that is very common in adults, less common in children, is the pityriasis rosea, characterized by a larger lesion that is called the mother patch, then followed by the small patches, usually affecting trunk and less commonly affecting the arms and the limbs. It is often associated with this inner border of scaling in patients, sometimes secondary to an herpes virus 6 infection of the upper respiratory tract. And we are going to the end with this, in my view, overlooked condition, usually affecting children, but also sometimes affecting adults, that is characterized by this singular, monolateral, and periflexural involvement of the skin in patients after a fever or some systemic symptoms, like in this other patient. This condition is secondary to viral infection as well, and its name is asymmetric periflexural exanthema of childhood, also in this case, like we said in Giannotti Crossi disease, the evolution is benign and spontaneously towards the spontaneous resolution of the condition itself. Thanks for listening.